So CNN just released a new poll of the New Hampshire primary, and it's showing an increasing two-horse race between Bernie Sanders and Pete Buttigieg. Bernie is at 28%, Buttigieg at 21%, Joe Biden at 11%, and Elizabeth Warren at 9%. And this is showing that in the aftermath of Iowa, Bernie Sanders and Pete Buttigieg are rising, and most of the other top candidates are falling. And the numbers bear that out here. Compared to the last CNN poll done of New Hampshire, Bernie is up 3. That's decent growth for a frontrunner. And Pete Buttigieg really does seem to be benefiting from Joe Biden's collapse. He's up 6 points here. Biden himself is down 5, and Warren is down 3. And so basically, at this stage, Bernie Sanders and Pete Buttigieg may well be the only ones viable for significant delegates in New Hampshire, given that Warren and Biden are both well below 15%. Warren herself falling into the single digits. No one else besides Bernie and Buttigieg is even close to 15%, given that we're only a few days out from the New Hampshire primary on Tuesday. All of this is demonstrating that this particular state is still there for Bernie to get, but his supporters need to be cognizant of the fact that they can't take anything for granted. Bernie needs to win New Hampshire, and he needs to win convincingly over Buttigieg, not only to set a narrative, but also to win every last delegate he can. Because when it comes down to convention, Bernie Sanders needs to try to get as close as he can to winning on that first ballot as is humanly possible, so that the superdelegates don't all coalesce around an anti-Bernie candidate, or that a series of the neoliberal candidates don't try to pool their delegates around a consensus candidate to effectively steal the nomination from Bernie. Bernie needs to hit that threshold, or at least be so close to it, that only flipping a few delegates from other people would get Bernie over the hump. That's what Bernie Sanders needs to do to win the nomination. And big wins in states like New Hampshire are part of that package. This is also showing that Elizabeth Warren's time in this race may well be done. For those who have watched this channel over a long time, since the beginning, I had a lot of great things to say about Elizabeth Warren, especially early on. I feel that besides Bernie Sanders, she has the best policy in the field. But given her actions in flip-flopping on the necessity of Medicare for all immediately, and given her actions on the flip-flopping of corporate financing, and given her acceptance of billionaire donors, and given her insistence on attacking Bernie Sanders through lies and misinformation, my opinion of her has gone way downhill. I still think, despite all of that, she's probably the second best in the race. But at this stage, if this polling is accurate, if Warren ends up having this bad of a New Hampshire, she owes it to every progressive American to immediately drop out, to give all of her delegates to Bernie Sanders, and to endorse him and encourage all of her supporters to move to Bernie Sanders. That's what she absolutely needs to do. If she is polling at 7 or 8 or 9% in a state like New Hampshire, it is 100% over for Elizabeth Warren. If Warren was ever going to be competitive in this sort of primary in general, she needed to do very well in white New England states like New Hampshire to really offset her weaknesses in southern and more conservative states, states that are more diverse. That was the bare minimum for Warren, was a strong New Hampshire, maybe a strong second. She's in a distant fourth. So she needs to drop out and endorse Bernie and basically try to put the water under the bridge, given what she said about Bernie over the last few weeks. But one really important piece of data from this poll that I think will go under-examined relative to the top line numbers is the perception of people in terms of the broader race. Because going back to earlier polls, even just a couple of weeks ago, and I've noted this, Bernie's Achilles heel and Joe Biden's saving grace was the electability question. Things were predicated on the fact that Joe Biden was the one that could best defeat Donald Trump. And because of that, he was getting a lot of support from people, not because they loved him or were inspired by him, but because they were thinking in a pragmatic desire to elect the next president. But Bernie Sanders in this poll is now seen by New Hampshire voters as more likely to win in November than Joe Biden. Bernie Sanders is seen by 29% of people to be the one to defeat Donald Trump. Joe Biden, 25, and Pete Buttigieg, 14. But it's crucial to note the swing here. Relative to the last poll, Bernie Sanders is up 9% on this question, and Joe Biden is down 16. Buttigieg, he's up 6. But that means that there's effectively a 25% swing from Biden to Bernie on the question of who is most likely to win the election in November. That's drastic. And I've noted this before, that Joe Biden is in real trouble the second that people start to doubt if he's the guy that can defeat Donald Trump. As soon as he loses that, he loses almost everything. Because no one really likes Joe Biden. No one's inspired by Joe Biden. None of Joe Biden's programs are so interesting and essential and unique that there's a reason to vote for him and not vote for Bernie or Warren or Buttigieg or Klobuchar or anybody else. He's got nothing but the anti-Trump argument. If he loses that, he is done. And that's why, given all of this, and I've noted this before, 538, the political prediction website by Nate Silver and others, projects that Bernie Sanders will win every single remaining primary with the exception of Alabama, one of the most conservative states in the United States, and Delaware, Joe Biden's home state. Biden is projected to narrowly win both of those primaries. And it's showing that as Joe Biden collapses and as the arguments around Joe Biden's candidacy collapse, Bernie Sanders is starting to fill the void as the unequivocal frontrunner. But we can't get complacent. Pete Buttigieg may well start to coalesce a lot of the neoliberal support behind him. People might leave from Biden to him, Klobuchar to him, and on and on and on. And at this stage, it's very important that Bernie Sanders get every last delegate possible. That when candidates like Yang and Gabbard and Warren drop out, that they hopefully endorse Bernie Sanders and bring their supporters to him. Because that's what it's going to take. Again, I have to stress this. Right now, if you look at 538, it's clear Bernie is the favorite to win the most delegates. But that is not enough. You have to win enough delegates to make your result unimpeachable. And right now, Bernie is on that edge. If Bernie underperforms a little bit, he might be short on delegates. If he overperforms, he might have enough. So that means it's not necessarily sufficient for Bernie to win the vast majority of states if he's not winning them by big enough margins. He needs to win big where he's strong, and he needs to narrow the gaps between him and Biden in the more conservative parts of the country. So from my perspective, Bernie Sanders won Iowa. I think he's going to win New Hampshire. And as we move on past that, it's about asserting that Bernie Sanders has all the momentum and that Bernie Sanders, and not Buttigieg and not Biden, is the best single candidate to defeat Donald Trump by building a mass movement of young people, of racialized people, of marginalized people to turn out in record numbers and depose one of the worst presidents in American history.